Sports Radio with Lincoln Kennedy. I'm Andy Furman, and joining us right now, the Messiah of the Midwest, the one, the only, Mike North. Northy, what's going on, Northy?
Well, first of all, we're doing something. We're taping this segment here for NorthToNorth.com tomorrow. So, you know what, Andy? When you get up in the morning, go to North to North. Well, about noon Chicago time, and you and Lincoln. By the way, how are you, gentlemen?
Hey,
great. What's up, Lake? What's up,
buddy?
You guys will be on tomorrow. This conversation is being taped for 5 minutes of the 30 and 5, also on 560 WIND.
Wow.
So, yeah, you're big shot. You're going to be all over the world, all over the country, Andy, as you already are, because you are America's guest. And, of course, everybody knows who Lincoln is. Everybody knows who Lincoln is.
That's about
Before there was the Tebow, there was the Lincoln Log.
Don't
ever forget that.
He's on a roll, Link, isn't he?
Yeah, I know. I was about to say, he got the Messiah of the Midwest, and I thought Tebow was coming on.
But well, then I'm just saying, Tebow, you know what? Hey, you know what? Tebow and Aaron Rodgers have something in common. They're both at home sitting. One can't throw and one can't. So what does that tell you? It's a team. You got
You can throw Drew Brees in there too.
Yeah, I mean, everybody's criticizing Tebow. He's sitting there. If he has a party, he can invite Drew Brees next week over Aaron Rodgers, all the great quarterbacks of all time, and he could say, you know, I can't throw, but you know, I got to the playoffs and got as far as you guys did. How'd that work for everybody?
Well, you know, but it is all about the quarterback. And if anybody reminded us about that, it was Tom Brady Saturday night, and it was really embarrassing what he did to the Denver Broncos. But question is, and we asked this to Chris Landry earlier tonight: what happens next year to Denver? Is it wide open for the quarterback position?
And what, you know what? And I would say this, I doubt it. I think that you got to give this kid another year. He's going to work out during the offseason. Hey, the week before, he throws for 316 yards. Everybody loves him. Here's what I know. They were in the playoffs. Nobody thought they'd be there.
True.
And he was there, and he helped get them there. And if they're going to investigate him, they might as well investigate what happened to Green Bay today. I mean, you're talking four or five turners. Now I'm hearing about this. Oh, they had the layoff. You know what? These guys are champions. They don't want to hear that, right? Like, they don't want to hear that they had a couple weeks off, and that's why they were rusty. Come on.
They couldn't catch the football.
No.
Well, if you would ask them if they wanted the layoff, I mean, take off, they would have told you yes.
Oh,
but But they also didn't think that they were going to be beaten by a team coming in there on their home turf.
No one
ever does.
No, but you know what? The team that beat them may win the Super Bowl.
Yeah, I mean, looking as good as they are, yeah.
Eli Manning's telling everybody, okay, I said I was elite. Y'all laughed at me. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, so guess what? I brought Ole Miss back. I've won a Super Bowl with the New York Giants already. I may do it again. And where does that put him then? If you have him winning two Super Bowls, if indeed that does happen. I think everybody's rooting for, or everybody's going to want to see maybe New England. What do you think everybody wants to see, New England versus New York? I don't. I'd like to see the 49ers in there.
Yeah, it's
with
a toss-up.
With the defense versus Brady.
Well, you know, but if it's all about the quarterback, I have my doubts with Alex Smith. I really do.
After what happened?
I still do. I really do.
I know. My parents have been doubting me, and I'm 59. They've been doubting me since I was a kid. I understand. You just can't get it. It's like we're so, I guess, inoculated with the bad Alex Smith. But since Harbaugh took over, Andy, it's been all good with this kid. This
you know, he his defense, but the defense and the special teams are so outstanding on that ball
and
club.
And Vernon Davis.
And Justin Smith is unbelievable.
Yeah. They have a good defense. They you know what? And by beating Drew Brees, New Orleans now, 0-4 on the road to the playoffs, guys.
I'm telling you, this is a team that's built for indoors. They're built for turf. You know what? I can't really put my finger on when you evaluate them.
Right.
But for whatever it seems, they go out there and they have their struggles. Now, they're not at the tip-top shape that you see them when they're at home and they're hosting somebody.
Right.
They go on the road, they seem to lose a little bit.
Yeah, well, because, you know, New York was just in the same elements that they would have been playing with at home today.
Exactly.
So I understand where you're coming from, and you're right. When they won it all, they had the home field advantage. So going on the road, Drew Brees has to prove, one of the great quarterbacks of this generation, has to prove that he can get it done next year if they do have to go out on the road. But, hey, you know what? The playoffs, I would consider, B plus as far as the games were concerned?
So far, You know, it's interesting that all the home teams except one won. I mean, it's a rarity that that's ever happened.
Yeah, and the major favorite was the one that lost.
Exactly.
By the way, I mean, this is what it's come to in my career. I'm sitting in for Andy tomorrow, Lincoln. This is the whole
thing.
Wow. Martin Luther King Day. I'm doing the turnaround.
You know what that's like? That's like Kobe Bryant not starting. Really? That's unbelievable. Really?
All the world, Andy.
You know
Andy,
what? I
Andy,
so
it's a privilege. It's
no,
a privilege.
I feel so bad. I may get up tomorrow morning and do it, really.
Can you give me a call?
Let a brother know, because he will be up to doing the show right now.
And Lincoln, I'm just going to wake you up because it is Martin Luther King Day. I'm going to call you. Hey, I'm going to call you up, you know. I may have Jesse Jackson call you and give you a prank call.
Oh, please, because I'll never be able to hang up the phone with him.
Oh, no. That's my guy.
He likes Lorenzo Neal calling him up.
Oh, don't do that.
Oh, that's a classic bumper that people hear. I mean, Lorenzo Neal sold that, and Lincoln, you know what, as soon as he said, well, we played in some All-Star game.
Yeah, I was like, who is this? Like, exactly. A little high-pitched voice all running
about. I'll tell you what's great about our shows. You know what? Our shows are good, but the damn bumpers make our show sound a lot better than they really are. Let's be honest about it. My God, they plucked one or two moments of any of our shows, and we sound like geniuses, don't we?
It's must-listen radio.
Andy was just saying, what are you talking about, man?
Exactly. They're still looking for my bumper, really.
Flood Brothers Disposal and Recycling Services are professional waste haulers. Now, the Flood family is big on service. It's our number one priority, and we offer extremely competitive pricing because the Flood family is here to help you in this tough economy. Remember, at Flood Brothers, we build relationships, and the only thing we're big on is service. Call us at 773-626-5800 or floodbrothersdisposal.com.